All right, Shalom Israel. I'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shah, that one is to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone, and Shalom to Lek out there, doing his work of faith, and labor of love and true sincerity. To brother from JMS Soldiers of Faith, New Jersey camp, you know, just coming in the spirit, you know what I'm saying, after camp on a late night, you know, brothers chopping it up, you know what I mean, brotherly love and all that. You know, just wanted to come with a quick open form. You know what I'm saying? Through the spirit of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shah, you know, just Lord willing, the segment is edifying out there, the Akim. So,
it's the book of 1st Ezra, chapter 4. We'll start at verse 32. It says, O ye men, how can it be but women should be strong, seeing they do thus? Then the king and the princes look one upon another. So he began to speak of the truth. O ye men, are not women strong? Great is the earth, high is the heaven, swift is the sun in his course. For he compasseth the heavens round about, and fetcheth his course against his own place in one day. It's verse 35. Is he not great that maketh these things? Therefore great is the truth, and stronger than all things. All the earth calleth upon the truth, and the heaven blesseth it. All works shake and tremble at it, and with it is no unrighteous thing.
Right, and you know, them getting into this, there was comparing, you know, different things of what they thought was more powerful. You know, but ultimately, what is the most powerful thing upon the face of the earth is this truth, man. You know, and like the brothers down in DC, where they got into you know, the lesson about, you know, IUIC and them, you know what I'm saying, saying that the 144,000 consisted of, you know what I'm saying, all of the elect and the great multitude and all of that. And they broke it down through the simple math, you know what I'm saying, which math comes from truth, man. So, you know, the truth of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah is reigning throughout the earth constantly, man. And the truth is going to stand forevermore over top of anything with Esau upholds highest thing within a society, man. And we have that truth through the grace and spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah and through our apostles and elders of Great Millstone, man. You know, the truth of this earth is going to continue to spring through his prophets, through his men of the Lord, man, who out there on them highways and byways, week in and week out, you know, bringing about the destruction and downfall that's coming to head in this society known as America, aka Babylon the Great, man. You know, people are going to wake up and know who the true Israelites are. Majority of the people around the world may do know. They may give a blind eye to it, but they know what's going on, man. They see the things that's happening, going on constantly, day after day, you know? But it's going to come to that point in time where Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah is going to put it plain in their face, and they're not going to be able to deny it, man. They're going to accept us as actually being, you know, the true Hebrew Israelites as recorded in the scriptures, as we know we are. And they're going to accept Esau as a devil according to the scriptures, man. Esau is being revealed day in and day out, man. Every single day. You know? It's more than that.
Verse 37. Wine is wicked. Mm-hmm. The king is wicked. Women are wicked. Mm-hmm. All the children of men are wicked.
Mm-hmm. All the other nations are wicked, God.
And such are all their wicked works.
Mm-hmm. So everything upon this face of the earth, you know, the women, wine, because the scriptures talk about wine being a mocker. You know what I'm saying? And things like that, you know, the kings of the earth that set up, you know, the kings of the different nations, they all wicked, man. But what stands out? What stands out? What is that shining that God and light? The truth that Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah has set up upon his men through Great Millstone, first and foremost, man. It's not being done out there by any of them other Israelite groups out there, man. You know, through Great Millstone, the truth shall spring and flourish through the earth. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah constantly until the end time come, man. To the very bitter end come, you know?
I got a quick precept, right? Because this situation that happened represents truth. And one thing about the truth, you can't fight it, but you can't deny it. The only thing you can do is accept it, you know? But it's the book of Acts, chapter 4. I'm gonna start at verse 12. It says, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Now when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled and they took knowledge of them, that they had been with Yahweh Shah, you know, because what? Of the truth, the doctrine that Yahweh Shah was pushing, you know. Peter and John, the authority that they was coming in, the spirit that they was coming in, you know, the men of that area knew that they must have commiserated with Yahweh Shah, you know, by their boldness, you know. It says verse 14, and beholding the man which was healed standing with them, they could say nothing against it. But when they had commanded them to go aside out of the council, they conferred among themselves, saying, what shall we do to these men? For that indeed a notable miracle hath been done by them is manifest to all them that dwell in Jerusalem, and we cannot deny it. So the miracles that the apostles were doing in the ancient world 2,000 years ago, it was a notable miracle. Because why? It represented truth. Ultimately, it represented Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah. You know, so just like in this present time, we work in miracles too, man. You know, here it is, the world is, you know, walking around in gross darkness. You know, they're walking around believing lies. You know, but when we come out with this truth through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah, we're able to open the eyes of the blind, man. And that's a miracle that's being done, man. You know, because why? The scriptures, the prophecies that's written, you know, is in harmony with the acts and the current events that's being shown today, man. And what? It's opening those whose eyes are meant to be open, which is a miracle, right? Which represents truth. Reading on, it says verse 17, but that it spread no further among the people, let us straightly threaten them that they speak henceforth to no man in this name. And they called them and commanded them not to speak at all, nor teach in the name of Yahweh Shah, because they know it's truth, man. And ultimately, when you speak truth, you know, and once truth gets published and showcased and exalted, what's naturally going to happen? People are going to follow it. People is going to begin to hearken unto it. So the only way you can come against the truth is to threaten those who speak in truth. And what this devil's going to use, what you may fear against you, you know, which is death, you know, imprisonment, things of that nature. But if you don't have no fear of death nor imprisonment, guess what? The spirit naturally is going to be within you to further push the truth, man, to further exalt the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah and exhort the brotherhood, you know. Just to finish it off, verse 19, but Peter and John answered and said unto them, whether it be right in the sight of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shah to hearken unto you more than unto the God, judge ye, for we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard. And what is that? Truth, you know. So we can't do nothing but to speak truth, man. Because why? We are witnesses of Yahweh Shah. If you're a witness, you know, you're compelled to testify, you know, of what you've seen, you know. And we see the truth because why? We have faith. What is faith? Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. But we see it, man. We have the vision, you know.
Amen. And that's why everybody hates us, you know, because in Galatians it tells you, am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth? You know, that's what we set up to do. We set up to tell the truth, to reprove the nations and to reprove our people, man. So when we putting that truth, that God and light upon the people to show them their wickedness, they don't like that. So therefore they lash out us in return for that, man. You know, they show us evil for the good that we showing them, as Jeremiah was getting into. That's why he put the curse up on 2/3, which curse still through the reincarnation is being brought back onto them to this day, man. You know?
Last scripture, verse 21. It says, so when they had heard further, it says, when they had further threatened them, they let them go, finding nothing how they might punish them because of the people. For all men glorified Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai for that which was done. For the man was above 40 years old and on whom this miracle of healing was showed.
That's more than that, Ezra's.
Yeah, it's 1st Ezra chapter 4. I'm going to start at verse 37 again. It says, wine is wicked, the king is wicked, women are wicked, all the children of men are wicked, and such are all their wicked works, and there is no truth in them. Mm-hmm. in their unrighteousness also they shall perish. As for the truth, it endureth and is always strong. It liveth and conquereth forevermore.
Hey, and that's why, you know, Esau can try to do whatever they want to do, but why couldn't they bury the Israelites? Because the Lord kept truth in the earth, man. The Lord had his devils write the records out throughout the time periods of history that the Israel's name will continue to be in remembrance and brought up for us to this day, man. You know, when the Lord opened up, you know, the eyes of what Abba Bivis and passing on down the torch, you know, through the elders that were over there, apostles, now the apostles are passing that knowledge on down to us, man. The Lord constantly left that record there in these scriptures. This is the record, you know, first and foremost, before all the other secular history, you know, but that further proves the scriptures and who we are as a people. So the Lord left that paper trail, so to speak, so that we can get back into our heritage and prove that truth shall continue to flourish throughout the earth, man. You know, and we are living examples of that, man. How can you take it, so-called Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans from the ghettos and slums from America, Europe, and all across the world, waking up and actually doing something with the world would consider positive, man, when this is the best thing that we could ever do for our lives, period, man, greater than anything throughout the face of the earth in general, man, you know? And we are those men, because Brothers was getting into it earlier, which you were saying, Brother, pretty much like our, what you're saying is like, it's nothing better than being a prophet or something like that?
Yeah.
Or what the other brothers were saying, something like that?
With the brothers, the brother Karab, Barack Abar, and the other brother, I don't know his name, but they did a beautiful sit-down. I believe it was, I keep forgetting the name of the title, I've just seen it. Basically that, you know, brothers that's in this truth, you know, we are much valued than you think you are. You're the most important people, men on this planet. You know what I'm saying? And that was touching to me. And that's very important and edifying because that's truth. You know, the Lord's elect, especially dealing with his men, you know, the 144,000, you know, dealing with the Lord's men, they're the most important people on this planet. Just harping upon stemming the ball from the spirit that the brothers was doing a lesson on, man.
It's a Psalm chapter 85, the third verse 9. It says, surely his salvation is nigh them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other.
Hey, and that's key right there. Mercy and truth. We having mercy within these last times under the law. You know what I'm saying? And truth. The truth is Yahweh Shah. In John 1 and 17, it says, Moses brought the law, but grace and truth came of Yahweh Shah. So now within these times, mercy and truth is combining one another. They're kissing one another, man. And righteousness through the prophets of the Lord, through the Lord's God and light, which are his men, you know?
Verse 11, truth shall spring out of the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven.
Yeah, this truth going to spring up. Truth is going to trump lies. You know, righteousness is going to trump wickedness. You know, wickedness had reigned through the earth, through the Edomites, you know, for a long time, for a short period of time, you know, a short season. And it deceived many people in a short time. Like even the false lie about who the Messiah looked like, you know, who they call upon, Jesus Christ. Well, righteousness is going to trump over wickedness, man. Scoffers will not gainsay against this truth. It won't work. There's nothing you can do to hurt or to stop this truth. And Esau will tell you himself if he's in his right mind. I mean, he's a lying devil, but if he tell you and be honest with you, we know you devils can't stop this truth. We know your mindset, but we know that what, like the brother had me mention in camp today, is that you can't stop the truth. But what you can do is try to bring some form of distraction, you know, distraction to the truth, or some type of slowing down prophecy. Because Esau then tried to defeat prophecy, which is the prophecies of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh, Shah. You know, they tried going to the moon. They tried blowing up the moon. You know, they tried going and measuring the depths of the sea. They tried to measure the stars of heaven. You know, all the stars out there in the galaxy, man. Mm. But they can't. So the only thing that these devils can to the sense of mind, you know, reality is that, well, if we can't defeat prophecy, let's slow it down. Scriptures tell us that they have but a short time to rule, you know, a short time, you know, to come down. You know, that's it. So how much more they little pawns and agents who's trying to, you know, hopefully disrupt or deceive the minds of the Lord's elect. The scriptures tell you that you can't deceive the Lord's elect. So whoever the Lord elect is, you can't deceive them. And who is the Lord? The Lord is only focuses upon his elect right now. Two-thirds of the Lord people going to die. So who is the Lord's really focus on? His elect.
And why can't you deceive the Lord's elect? Because they represent truth. The deceive runs parallel with lies. Truth buries lies, man. That's why we just brought the scripture, Psalms 85 and 11. Truth shall spring out of the earth. You know, why is truth going to spring out of the earth? Because there was a particular moment in time to where lies was being published. You know, but we're in the season now to where the truth is being broadcasted around the four corners of the earth, man.
Hey, real quick, just to quote the scripture, mm-hmm. The Lord said to deceive and deceiver is this. Mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah. Because why? The Lord governeth the world in the palm of his hand. You know, and we're in a time now to where the Lord is dividing the holy from the profane, man.
Right. And we've been taught lies for hundreds of years now, man. When we was over there, you know, after we had to flee from the Roman persecution, we was blown over there in Africa, you know, for that period of time, you know, at least we still kept some of the customs, the rites and rituals, and us knowing actually who we are, you know. But as it gets into in the book of Revelation, I believe the 11th chapter, you know, pretty much us being over here, the spiritual Sodom in Egypt, also where our Lord was crucified, here is where we forgot everything, man. So from, you know, them devils, you know, starting off with Christopher Columbus, so on and so forth, the Borgias and, you know, the Portuguese, the Spanish and all of that, you know, taking us from over there in the west coast of Africa, bringing us over here, you know what I'm saying, beating the truth out of us, man, beating who we are up out of us, man, and to feed our people them constant lies for us to be actually deceived within our minds, you know, to trust everything that the so-called white man is telling them, not knowing that he's the devil that's been doing this the whole time, and our people actually accepted him as the savior who's been doing us dirty for hundreds of goddamn years, man.
Hey, Salaki, if I could add, like that movie, Usual Suspects, you know, he made that statement, what was the greatest trick the devil ever pulled? Was convincing the world that he didn't exist. And that's what this devil did, man. He proved the world that he wasn't the devil that the Bible speaks of. Because why? He painted that image of Cesare Borgia, as if he was the Lord and Savior, man.
Yeah, brother got a quick piece of it. Jeremiah 17:4, and thou even thyself shalt discontinue from thine heritage that I gave thee, and that will cause thee to serve thine enemies in the land which thou knowest. So that edifies the point with the brother Shalomai he was talking about. You know, you shall discontinue from thy heritage, meaning that you shall, you know, like how you doing basketball, we call it discontinue. Yeah. You know, you have inheritance, you have a starting point, but then you shall stop for a moment, but then you shall gather it again. You know? So that's what happened. Read it again, Salah.
And thou even thyself shall discontinue from thy heritage.
Which are the Israelites. The Lord has given us back his name. He's given us back our identity, which is raped and robbed from us. We know who we are. You know? Only the deceived can be the deceived, can be deceived, man. You see that? The Lord put the spirit down upon who he has chosen.
Sure.
And the chosen is not going to be deceived or winnowing with different spirits or drinking Babylonian juice. You know, drinking the wine. So read it again, Salah.
And thou even thyself shalt discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee. And I will cause thee to serve thine enemies in the land which thou knowest not.
We in a land where our enemies, which we knew,
Jeremiah 17:4, now we thyself shall discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee. And I will cause thee to serve thine enemies in the land which shall know it's not.
Yeah, because the land that we know of not is this land of North America. We didn't know this part of the land because it was a wilderness back when we was in the eastern part of the world. And we're serving our enemy, which is the Edomite. Every day you serve the Edomites. It's not a day that the Edomites don't have a foot in your ass. You know? You think you people are free. Two-thirds of our people think they're fucking free. Right. You think that you make a difference. You ain't making a difference if you ain't speaking up your Yahweh Shah. All you doing is fulfilling the will of Edom. You go to work and you get taxed to pay Edom, to pay the international bankers. This land here is what? A corporation.
Business.
A business. Mm-hmm. America is not an actual place, a place of freedom. Yeah. It's a business here. You work and you're conditioned in your mind to work for them. You're a slave, man.
Yeah, I was just gonna say, like, America is the only place where you're free to do wickedness, man. Because the madness that America upholds, if you take that over there to certain parts of the Middle East, you'd be put to death, man. Like adultery, for an example, man. You know, here it is, America, you know, first and foremost, the scriptures say, how the Lord will create a new thing in the earth, a woman shall compass a man. That's not being upheld out there in the Middle East, man. They don't put the woman over the man in the Middle East. And if she's found committing an act of adultery, they stone her ass, man. You know, but what, in Babylon the Great, adultery is being promoted, man. You know, by way of the social media, by way of reality TV, as well as the music, man. You know?
Yeah, I got a quick insert from the elder in the chat. And then on the comment board, Elder Not Desire, GMS contending for faith, I mean, contending for truth. It says, Isaiah 62 and 61, it says, I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, which shall never hold their peace day nor night. Ye that make mention of the Lord Yahweh, keep not silence. You know, and brothers prophesying at 1:40 in the morning.
This truth
going out. You know, this truth going out day nor night. And if you don't catch it live tonight, you know, you will catch this word tomorrow, you know? Yeah. So the elders putting that out there because this truth is going out. We at the end, man. We at the end. There's nothing else that we living for. You know, you got to live every day, you know, as far as your last, man. What else is there you living for? We in this truth, you give your body as a living sacrifice, do the works of the Lord. You know, so we striving to be those men, Lord willing, we are, man. You know?
It's Job chapter 8, verse 3. Does God pervert judgment? Or does the Almighty pervert justice? Like the brother was getting into, you know, in this case called Babylon, which is, you know, great confusion, man. Our people was trodden down in slavery to God who we are for a number of years, man. But as you can see, we came back to our heritage, man. It's continued, man. Stop at one point and then to continue again. All right, it says, if our children have sinned against them, we have cast them away for their transgressions, which he did with us, man. God who we was. Verse 5, God would have seeking to God be time and make thy supplication to the Almighty. If thou wert pure and upright, surely now he would await for thee and make thy habitation of thy righteousness prosperous. You know, and that's showing you how our truth is going to return back unto them, you know, saying that practice in her, you know, which we know is the elect.
Right.
The elect's going to get this truth.
And who's responsible for us discontinuing from our heritage, man? The so-called white man, man. Esau, Edom is responsible for that, man. Trying to bury everything of the truth possible within their power, but the Lord would not allow them to completely do away with the records, man. You know, because in Jeremiah, the 31st chapter, you know, the Lord said if he would do away with the ordinances of heaven, then he would do away with the nation of Israel. So since the Lord wasn't going to do that, there's no way, you know, that Esau was going to completely do away with the Israelites, man, a so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, man. There's no way that he was going to do that. But as I was getting into earlier, the Lord always set it up for us to be able to come back into the fold, man, because this was all in his plan. This is his movie, his script, as we was getting into early in camp, you know. And real quick, this is the book of Songs of Three Holy Children, 1 and 9. And thou didst deliver us into the hands of lawless enemies, the most hateful forsakers of Yahweh, and to an unjust king, and the most wicked in all the world. So this is the most wickedest place that I've ever been, you know, since the world began, man. 10 times wicked, more wicked than Sodom and Gomorrah. 10 times wicked than ancient Greece, than ancient Rome, okay? All of them places, man. This is the Mecca of where the destruction is going to take place at, man, so to speak, man. You know, the Lord have reserved that big cup of wine of judgment for America to receive to get their ass bust, man, for everything in which they've done unto the Israelites, man. This is the worst state our people have ever been in throughout all the captivities that's ever been upon the face of the earth, man. You know, when you look, you know what I'm saying, and you're walking down the streets of Nob, Irvington, or whatever place that you may live, and you see your people in poverty, see your people drug stricken down, you know what I'm saying, and welfare lines, you know what I'm saying, and the cheap supermarkets getting the bad food, man. It's one store in Nob. You know what I'm saying? And all of the products in there is expired, but people still buy shit anyway, man. This is hell, man. This is complete hell. And that's how you know that this society was not set up for us, and that Esau got to be the devil that the Bible speaks of, man.
Hey, real quick, and if I can add, you know, what also symbolizes this place being the most wicked kingdom ever and the worst captivity that Israel has ever experienced is because this is the only captivity that we've been in. It was on the whole, we don't know who we are. You know, you ask the average Jake, they're not going to tell you that their nationality is the Israelite. You know, you ask Jake, what's an Israelite? One tribe is going to tell you they're Puerto Rican. You know, another tribe is going to tell you he's a Muslim. Another tribe is going to tell you that he's an African American. Another tribe is going to tell you that he's a Haitian man. Why? Because the so-called white man Esau claimed himself to be the children of the Heavenly Father. You know, he was able to pull that off, you know, and indoctrinate us through hardcore bondage slavery because he had an agenda. He had an agenda that he was going to claim himself as to be the people of the Bible, you know, and two different nationalities can't claim the same nationality, also known as the children of the Heavenly Father. So with this devil knowing that he's in power, he was going to put us down and give us bywords such as Negroes, Mexicans, Colombians, so on and so forth, and claim himself as being God's chosen people. You know, that's what also symbolizes this place as being the worst kingdom that Israel has ever experienced. But like the brothers bringing out, Jeremiah 17:4, it was set up that way because we were going to have to discontinue from our heritage. When you read the book of Judges, you know, Israel will repent, then go off, repent, go off, repent, and go off. You know, we wouldn't be able to do that if the Lord didn't take his name from us and take our nationality from us. You know, but what, we had to go through that hell. We had to go through this hardship and bondage, you know, for us to be able to appreciate, you know, which is yet to come, which is the kingdom of heaven. Man.
Quick preacher. There's Job 12:22. He discovereth deep things out of darkness and bringeth out to light the shadow of death, man. So through his prophets, that's how he bring out to light the shadow of death, man. You know, because that's what this place is. This is the valley of the shadow of death. So the Lord has bringing out how, you know, about to get into how people think, you know, America was set up for our freedom and different things like that. This is actually set up for our bondage, man. So through his prophets, through his men, we're showing you, you know, through the script, according to the scriptures, that this place is the shadow of death, that there's nothing righteous within this place, man. You know, but you have these people upholding different laws within the society, conforming their minds to the mannerisms of the society. You know, everything about America nowadays is feminine, man. You know, from the clothes to the way people walk, the way people talk. You can't even be a man and express your opinion, how you actually feel about a certain thing, without getting heavily criticized on something, man. You know, them asking you to tone it down or people having to retract certain statements they make or having to apologize for them having an opinion, man. It's no rights, no freedom, no nothing here, man. So why would people want to continue to live within a society just as this, man? Why would they want to continue to conform their mind into the ways and the standards, which is lowering your vibration you know what I'm saying, of how we're supposed to be as us being the Israelites, as us being that royal people, man, you know?
Right. Yeah, because, you know, the Lord gave us back our identity, and the Lord's not about to take that away. You know, when he gave it back to us, and you have these Edomites that want to keep this Christianity vibration going because it was successful once again. It was working. And now the Lord told us what? Righteousness shall shine before darkness. So therefore, truth shall trump over wickedness, man. Going back into that. And then two devils, you know, your lies is not going to live forever. You shall be brought to the light, man. You know, so with the Lord giving us this identity, giving us our identity back, you can't take that away, man.
You got something there?
Yeah, I got something. This is, right, this is Ezekiel chapter 36, and I'll start at 20. It says, and when they entered into the heathen, whether they went, matter of fact, I started at 16. It says, moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, son of man, when the house of Israel dwelt in their own land, they defiled it with their own way. And by their doings, their way was before me as uncleanness of a removed woman. The verse will bring it down as I go. It says, wherefore I poured my fury upon them for the blood that they had shed upon the land, and for their idols wherewith they had polluted it. And I scattered them among the heathen, and they were dispersed through the countries.
And that's the reason why we got confused in the faces to this day. You know, that's part of the curses that fell upon the nation of Israel. Because Israel was into idolatry, you know, worshiping idols, you know, worshiping every power but Yahweh Basim Yahushah. You know, so for that cause, the Lord spreaded us and scattered us upon the nations, man. So when you got certain Israelites that are Israelites, but they don't know they're Israelites, because they may look like the so-called Chinese, they may look like the so-called African, they may look like the so-called Jew, they may look like, you know, a Japhite, you know, being Hawaiian or whatever the case may be. But what? Ultimately, that's why this word is going out throughout the four corners of the earth. Because why? Israel's been scattered throughout the four corners of the earth, and the Lord is coming for his elect. The Lord is coming for his chosen, man. You know?
Yeah, and that's the spirit, too, you know, because your brother put up the confusion of faces, you know, earlier today in camp, you know what I'm saying, a young dude, you know what I'm saying, he came through, he looked like he was in the army, you know what I'm saying, brother stopped him, you know, started talking to him, and the spirit had it to where, you know, he came by the camp for a specific reason, you know, because tomorrow he was supposed to go forth and, you know, make his oath. You know what I'm saying? To say forth that when he turned 18, that he's going to go and join the army. So the Lord brought him through the camp, you know, and come to find out, you know, his father was Italian, you know, he read his spirit, you know, we came to the conclusion, you know, he got to be a Jake, man. You know, so it was, you know, and it was beautiful, you know what I'm saying? Brothers feed him through the word, and hopefully, you know, the word got unto him, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, he don't, you know, do that bullshit, you know, when he come back out the following week, man. You know, but that just goes to show you, you know, that the Lord is, with his chosen, man. You know what I'm saying? The Lord is going to weed out those who you want to weed out, man. You know what I'm saying? And going into the thing about the four corners of the earth or whatever, you know, like he's you know, a so-called Italian or whatever, but he didn't have no idea, you know, that he could be of God's chosen people. You know, he probably just grew up his whole life thinking he was mixed. You know what I'm saying? His father's Italian, his mother's Ephraim. You know what I'm saying? But little did he know that he's of God's chosen people, man, to show you how the Lord works, man. You know?
If I can add right quick too, because well, it was found out, you know, off of the record, but the young man's name was Divine Justice. That's spiritual in itself, man. Divine Justice. You know, we looked up, well, I looked up the word divine, and it pretty much means of or relating to the Heavenly Father. You know? So here it is, he looks like an Edomite, but he has a spiritual name, man. You know, and that name was placed upon him.
Yeah, that kills the spirit of these devils calling us black Hebrew Israelites. Because the Lord told us from scriptures, he dispersed us in the four corners. That means extrapolating. We know in the spirit that he's going to have Israelites that don't look like the regular, typical Israelite. Round face, you know, afro, woolly hair, they're gonna be confusing the faces, you know? And our people, you know, you gotta understand, you got these other camps that that want only want Negroes to be Israelites. The Lord is bigoted. Lord is, it's mine. He said, my thoughts are not your thoughts. My ways are not your ways. Why would the Lord limit us to just all be Negroes? You got this certain candidate to say that the northern tribes are not Israelites. Fucking fools, man.
Because but that's a tactic. They just want to limit the elect and wake them up. You know, destroy the hope of the elect.
Mm-hmm.
You know, by saying black people are Israelites. Knowing all of these niggas around America is not going to wake up. Man.
And Pastor Sahar, did a video responding on one of these Edomites that's trying to go over the picture of the Lord.
Yeah.
You know, it's the end. That's it.
The jig is up.
That's it. That's it, man. You ain't got nothing else to do but to be violent, man. So, I had more on the scripture, but.
Hey, real quick, a brother in the comment board, Arthur Sims, put beautiful scripture. I mean, I can break it down. 2 Peter 2:18 and verse 19. For when they speak great swelling words of vanity, they allure through the lust of the flesh.
See, and that's the lust of the flesh. Everybody is about their flesh.
Yeah.
Fucking carnal. Yeah. And carnalness leads to death. Yeah. That's what the scriptures say. That's what the words say. You got. I hate to keep bringing, I'm not going to sit here and name the names of these niggas because they ain't going to bring them up because they're less important, but it is for the season. Fuck y'all niggas.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? You niggas are scoffers, man. And you playing on the minds that are simple and you look, you know what I'm saying? You of the flesh. Like I said earlier, we was in camp. When you was in high school and you was in class and how you was brought up and raised, your peers around you will pressure you. And if somebody spoke disrespectfully to you, your peers around you would say, okay, well, it's your turn. What you gonna do about it?
Instigators.
Yeah, what you gonna do about it? He said, fuck you and your mother. You gonna take that or you a bitch ass nigga? That's what the world think. You living off your flesh. We prophets.
Right.
We spiritual men. You don't deal in the spirit as the same you deal with the flesh. The flesh gonna come. You just gotta wait upon it. You know, when the Lord put that spirit out, and we're going to wreak havoc upon you devils, man. Well, let's say the Lord first, because he said, I'm trying to press the loan.
Right.
Then after him, then we get whatever was left out, what's left, and we're going to demolish you through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashanel Shah. But we got to wait for that. So we're spiritual men. This is a spiritual warfare, you know? And when you in school, you get pressured by your peers, and what they do is that, what you going to do about it? So what you do, this is what you do, right? Because you are the flesh, you're learning of the flesh. You like, look. See me after school, we gonna fight. Now you're like, oh, yo, they gonna fight after school, son. Yo, they gonna fight, son. And now you think that because if you fight him, you gotta prove your point. Well, it don't work like that in this truth.
Yeah, two scriptures for you, bro. This is Proverbs chapter 15, verse 33. The fear of the Lord, Yahweh, is the instruction of wisdom. And before honor is humility.
See, before honor is humility. We in his truth, when we came into it, Sirach, what is the second chapter, tells us what we against. So when we came into this truth, we knew that we was going to be humiliated.
Right.
Humiliated.
Yeah.
We supposed to take the L all day through the flesh. But through the spirit, we win. Every day.
Every time.
We conquer. Paul said we're more than conquerors through him that love us, man. So anything that these niggas talking about and bringing up and pulling up your personal identification, nigga, you ain't doing nothing.
It's the flesh.
You ain't doing nothing. You're not stopping this man from going out to teach the word.
Right.
What's going to happen? What you said is going to get old. What the prophets are saying, always irrelevant. Always current.
So real quick too, this Proverbs 16:32. He that is slow to anger is better than the mighty. And he that ruleth his spirit than he that taketh a city.
Because you're not supposed to take vengeance upon your own hand.
Right.
You hold your tongue, man, you're stronger than the mighty. A nigga that's carnal minded gonna jump quick off the flesh. Nigga, what you say? What?
Right.
What? Yeah. Nigga, fight me then. Nigga, you can't beat me.
And them,
like,
them normally the niggas that get their ass whooped, you know? Because here it is, you moving, you reacting off of emotions, you fighting off of emotions. When you fighting off of emotions, you can't think straight. But here it is, if you calculate it, you know, in the midst of a fight, you know, and you ain't too angry, but you got a composure about yourself, you're able to think upon your next move and overtake your opponent, man. You know?
Hey, the Lord is long suffering. The Yahweh Shah is patient. Patience means suffering. So we're supposed to wait upon the Lord. You're supposed to count that loss as a gain in the Lord.
Exactly.
Because you're suffering righteously.
Yeah.
You know?
And wrongfully.
And wrongfully. You finish this real quick?
All right,
come and finish this. This is Ezekiel chapter 36 and 19. It says, and I scattered them among the heathen, and they and they were dispersed through the countries according to their way and according to their doings, I judged them. And when they entered into the heathen, whether they went, they profaned my holy name, going back until the name, and he's talking about the discontinuing and so on, right? It says, and when they entered into the heathen, whether they went, they profaned my holy name. When they said to them, these are the people of the Lord Yahweh and are going forth out of his land. But I had pity for my holy name, which the house of Israel had profaned among the heathen, whether they went. Therefore, say unto the house of Israel, thus say the Lord Yahweh, I do this for your sakes. It's like, I do this not for your sakes, O house of Israel, but for my holy name's sake, which ye have profaned among the heathen, whether they went. Now, I brought this out because that was the point we were talking about the name and the spirit, because the Lord gave us back our identity. You have to understand that. That's spiritual and so powerful because it's not just our identity, it's his name. It's his name that's within us, Israelites. He is the prince of the power, giving us his name to call upon him directly, that trumps over all spirits, whether left or right. He is the supreme power. It says, and I will sanctify my great name, which was profaned among the heathen, which ye have profaned in the midst of them, and the heathen shall know that I am the Lord Yahweh, say the Lord Yahweh, power, when I shall sanctify it in you before their eyes. So the Lord is sanctifying his name in us, you know, so that what? The world can know of him. He's using the people. And we was talking about earlier in camp, you know, about how we above, what's that, Deuteronomy 7?
7 and 6,
how we above and special people to the Lord. It's not that because he said it. He made us to be that way. It's in our gene. It's in our DNA. This is the way why Israelites are born with the salt. You're born with the salt because you carry the DNA. Well, you carry the Lord put it in us to be of him. On the earth, Esau wants to be us. Now, I think you said, you told me a minute ago how, like, by watching and researching and all that, how these devils, they to the point, they had the peak of their kingdom to where they figured that, look, we've studied you Israelites enough.
Right.
We know what you like and what you dislike and what makes you, you know, pop and move the way you do. We know your DNA. Now they want to take our DNA and put it inside them. These devils is on some transhuman shit, man. These devils sick, man.
Hey, these devils studied us to the teeth to where they want to make a movie upon the Israelites, the Hebrew Israelites, Asher. You know? You can't make a movie on something if you haven't scrutinized it. And that goes to show that they may even follow brothers in their liberty. Well, they do follow brothers in their liberty. You know, they got agents set up following you on your daily travels, man. You know, so if it's the Lord's will for that movie to come out, you know what I'm saying? It'll be showcased, man. You know?
These devils want daily activity from you. Before, it used to be, let's know his name. Let's get his school records.
Yeah.
Let's see where he from. Let's see where he live. It's not, it's deeper than that now. They want daily activity from you. They want to know, they want to be able to predict you. They want to say, he will say this next. This is the next thing he'll say.
Yeah.
That's how much they're monitoring, because they want to what? Sit in the seat of the Most High. They want to know your conscience. They want to read what your Yahawah Shem Yahavashah reads inside of you. The Lord reads the sincerity of a man, like he told Samuel. He said, look, I look within the inward part of man, not the outward part of man. Esau wants to do that. He wants to be able to do that without dealing with you, as if he's some type of power that sits in the seat of the Most High.
That's why the chip is there. The chip would allow him to do that, you know? And that's why the judgment for you taking the RFID chip, which is the mark of the beast, is thermonuclear missiles. That's the judgment, because you chose Esau, the so-called white man, to be your God, man. You know?
Yeah, I appreciate this. I want you to say it, Lord. So 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 4. Who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called God or that is worshipped, so that he as God sitteth in the temple of God, showing himself that he is God.
Look, Edom hath everything the heart could wish for. Got the fatness of the earth, the blessing of the sword. But he want more. You know what we was talking about earlier? He wanted to control your spirit now. He got the money. He got the power. He got everything a heart could wish for. But you know what he want? That he ain't satisfied. He wants your soul, man. He wants you to say, look, you know, this devil wants to be Yahweh. He wants to eliminate the power that created us, that gave the power to Yahawashah. All right. And wants to be the father and exclude the father out and make him of non-existence.
They want to be the father of spirits.
Yeah.
I got something for y'all real quick. Ezekiel 28:9. Will thou yet say before him that slave thee, I am God? But thou shalt be a man and no God in the hand of him that slave thee?
You know how many times niggas like you, these Edomites, came up against the Lord, and the Lord made you lower than a fucking ant, squashed you like a bug. Man, the king of Pharaoh in Egypt was just like you. That's why he raised them up, to show forth his name. So Edom, you just like him. You ain't nothing new to the Heavenly Father. Man, you old news, man. You old. Recycled. Hey, you recycled and you reincarnated, doing it again, thinking you can win. Stupid.
Right, because when you look at everything, it's characteristics to this thing, man. You know, you got characteristics of Jake, you got characteristics of Esau. The Lord set that up for a certain reason, so things could be firmly established and distinguished between the two.
Right.
So therefore, Edom, you can seek after everything in which we have, but you're never going to get it. You know what I'm saying? It's like they put something before an animal, you know what I'm saying, and stretch them and keep making them run after it. You know what I'm saying? It's like an apple or something, or a carrot in front of a fucking rabbit. They have them keep chasing. You're going to have them to keep chasing the fucking carrot, because you're not going to get it. Movies like Get Out show that you want to be like us, that you want to take our DNA and put it within yourself so that you can try to be the Jesse Owens and the Michael Jordans right. And the LeBron Jameses, so on and so forth, but it's not going to happen. You were set up to be the wicked of the earth, have no talent, no resource to do nothing. You're the parasite of the earth, man. And you had a so-called Jew, I forgot whether he is a so-called Jew or not, but the guy that did the book, matter of fact, Charles Wiseman, in the book, Who is Esau Edom? He said that the so-called Jew is a parasite. They have brought no value to no society that they've been in, man. Okay? But little do he know, that don't just apply for the so-called Jew, that apply for the whole nation of Edom as is, man. Y'all a damn parasite of the earth. We was made to cleanse the earth, to heal the earth, because we know how to properly till the soils and how to be one with the earth and be one with nature, man. You know, because that's how Yahawah Shemayah set it up to be, man. You know?
When you check it out, all of this wickedness started from jealousy, man. You know?
Yeah.
Starting with Cain and Abel.
Which he sold.
Starting with Cain and Abel. Cain killed Abel because he was jealous, man. Because Abel offered the right sacrifice. Coming back in the same in the reincarnation with Jacob and Esau. You know? It is, he sold the birthright, you know? And then ultimately, he was jealous because he received the blessing. He got supplanted for the blessing. And Esau knows what Jacob, Israel is going to be, the promises, the glory that is promised to Israel. So what? He's jealous of that. Mm-hmm. And what? He's going to do everything in his power to refrain us from obtaining that.
But he sold his birth. You sold it away.
Yeah, yeah.
So why are you mad?
That's what I'm saying. You sold it away.
Is you mad because you hate it or you hate it?
You sold your birthright. Yeah. If I sell you a pair of shoes,
yeah.
I can't see that. All right, I sell this brother a pair of shoes, right? And then I see that he's wearing them, and I be like, damn, you wearing them shits nice. Damn, them shits look good. Man, fuck that, I want them shits back. Yo, some of them shits back. Nah.
No, they look better on me.
And then I just hate you. Because it's like, man, y'all gonna steal them shits if I could. Right. Damn, I can't steal them though. So I can't get into his house.
Well, so what you gonna do? You gonna set up a scheme to try to kill him so you can get the shoes back?
Yeah. And thank you righteous for doing it.
And thank you righteous. And that's what Esau is doing.
Hey, because look at this, right? Because we all know what? Esau is not spiritual. You know what I'm saying? So he despised the birthright. Then afterwards, then he started to consider what the birthright was really worth after the fact. But it was too late.
Hey,
this is 2 Corinthians. This is just a quick example, right? 2 Corinthians 9:7. Every man according as he proposeth in his heart, so let him give. Right. It was in Edom's heart to give without the thought of it, right? Not grudgingly or out of necessity, for the Most High love a cheerful giver. Right. So when he gave it, after that, now he became grudgingly towards the gift that he gave.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's your fault, man. You can't be mad at nobody but your goddamn self, man. And you took the short end of the stick for yourself, man.
So in essence, with the Esau, he made a permanent decision on temporary feelings, man. You know? Yeah. And what? Ultimately, you're going to be destroyed for that because somebody grabbed Hebrews 12 and 16. You know?
Yes. Yeah, it says, lest there be any fornicator or profane person. 40? Oh, sorry. Hebrews 12 and 16. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person in Esau.
What's profane mean? Profane comes from the Latin profano, which means outside the temple. Esau, you became outside of the temple of Yahweh by Shem Yahweh, so the birthright. You know? So lest there be any profane person in Esau. You know, least pretty much meaning fear of man.
But really what God was spiritually coming back when he was a serpent.
Yeah.
You be God.
Yeah. You know, because ultimately Esau is the only nation that's not receiving mercy from Yahweh by Shem Yahweh, because he's going to be eradicated after 1,000 years of captivity. Right?
And for that, that's an important lesson in itself, just the fact that you're going outside the realms of, you know what I'm saying, of what the Most High allowed you to. Mm-hmm. So at this point, you know, you realize that you're not outside the realms, and that you got to pay for it, but you still won't, you know what I'm saying? You never learned your lesson.
Hey, and misery loves company, man. You know, here it is. Esau found himself trying to get back at Jake. Because here it is, he sold his birthright. And now we in the time now, he's in power. He wants to get Jake to sell out to him.
Yeah.
You know, so they can fall into the same judgment that he's going to receive.
Right.
You know, but ultimately, Israel's going to be saved, you know, in the kingdom. Mm-hmm. Only 2/3 going to be destroyed on this side. But you know, Esau is so miserable. He knows he's going down, and he's trying to bring a lot of Israelites down with him. Because he know in his spirit, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you know, we come from the line in which he sold his birthright to, man. You know? So here it is. He bestows the power. You know, he got all the resources. You know, he holds all the contracts. So now he provides Jake with false hope, man. You know? You sell out to me, I'll give you all the women that you could desire. All the jewelry, all the cars, all of the mansions, you know? And here it is, they tested upon him first. They let him get a taste of the lifestyle first. And once they get a taste and they like it, that's when they put that contract in front of them and they sell out, man. And then Esau got a smile on his face. And he think that he's getting over upon Jake. But what? Yahweh Shai always kept a cluster of grapes that's not gonna sell out. You know, that's why the Lord is dealing with a small number. Because all the Lord only needs a small number, you know, that's going to get delivered for him to flip this kingdom upside down, man. Well, I'm going to say right side up, you know.
real quick, because you know, like Esau, like our brothers get into, Esau knows exactly what he's doing, but this is their excuse, right? This is the excuse they try to put forth. It's Jeremiah 50:7 says, all that found them have devoured them, and their adversary said, we offend not, because they have sinned against the Lord, the habitation of justice, even the Lord, the hope of their fathers. Yeah. So they use that as their excuse. Like, hold up, we ain't commit no offense. They sinned against the Lord. You know what I'm saying? So we just reaping the benefits of it. Right. But at the same time, it's still judgment coming with you dealing with the Lord's chosen people in a certain manner, man. Right. So the Lord killing two birds in one stone, punishing us for our wickedness. Matter of fact, three birds right here. Punishing us for our wickedness, using you to be the whipping stick for us, and at the same time, we're going to return that same judgment upon your own head, double, man.
Yeah, because the Lord said there's no cure for your sins. See, for the Israelites' defense, the Lord sent out messages. He sent his prophets out there. Mm-hmm. And prophets been prophesying for years, starting with the apostles and the elders of great millstone, man. They've been prophesying for years. So there's no your excuse why you shouldn't understand this truth, why you shouldn't be able to get it, you know? The most I put that there, the chief Edomites, like the brother reading in the scriptures, man, that's a poor excuse. You can't come to the Lord with that. The Lord reads spirits.
Yeah.
You know, read your own spirit. He look at you and can tell that, you know, when the parables that he go into and say, you know, you know, a man full of blood, his hands are full of blood. What that mean? If he look at you, he see that your spirit, you full of evil and malice, man. You know, you full of blood, wickedness. There's nothing good in you. There's no righteous bone in Edomites. You know, so you Edomites not gonna make it, man. You know, you watch these videos and you might hit a dislike or you don't comment or you try to hope. And then you watch us and then you watch these other different camps and then these different camps like GOCC would say that Edomites could make it. Then you think you got a chance. So you support them, send them some money, you know, and all sorts of type of shit. Man, listen, man, none of you so-called white people, you Edomites, is going to make it. Now, do that disrupt the confusion of faces? No. If you look like an Edomite, but if your line going back to your father's line, your seed goes back to being an Israelite, you're going to make it. You have a chance. Hey, you're an Israelite. Put it like that. Yeah. You just got to hope that you're the elect to make it on this side before the second death. But you're an Israelite. But hey, man, you got it out of slot.
I got a quick scripture backing up the brother on Jeremiah 50:7. Because here it is. This devil, the so-called white man, Esau, he baits Israel. You know, he's in power, so he puts the bait out there and hope that we'll bite on it. You know what I'm saying? He put the laws out there to promote homosexuality. You know what I'm saying? He put the bait out there by setting up these rappers promoting adultery and things of that nature. So when you hear these things and you constantly see these things and you take hold of it, you know, he finds himself blameless because why? You bit the bait, you know? But what, we're in a time now to where you devils is being cast down. And this is Revelation chapter 12, verse 10. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, now is come salvation and strength and the kingdom of our power and the power of his anointed, for the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our power day and night. You know, because what, ultimately this devil is accusing us to the Father, but look, they going off, they committing adultery, they're out there committing murders, they out here smoking weed, they out here selling drugs, they out here doing all types of wickedness. We ain't doing nothing wrong. You know what I'm saying? So what, they accusing us day and night to the Heavenly Father, you know? But what, we in a season now to where these devils are being cast out, because why? This truth is coming out, you know? This devil, Esau, is being exposed based upon his wickedness, you know? And ultimately, how by Shem Yahshua is gonna reign supreme. When you read Judith, the fifth chapter, matter of fact, can somebody grab that right quick? Judith, the fifth chapter, you start at like 17. You know, the reason why this devil sets up, you know, this bait and he promotes all of these distractions is in the hopes to keep his kingdom flourishing, man. You know, and him reigning more than the boundary in which the Heavenly Father set upon him, man. You know? So we got to drop on you Edomites based upon the scriptures and how you operate, man.
Yeah, one quick point too. And what you fucking devils don't realize, man, even though Israel going off on a heavy level right now, the most wickedest Israelite, whoever he may be upon the face of the earth, is still more righteous than every one of you fucking Edomites, man. Every one of you, man. There's not a righteous bone in there one of you Edomites' body at all, man. The most wickedest Israelite nigga upon the face of the earth is still more righteous than you, because we are the saints of the Most High, man.
Right.
Yeah. Jeremiah 5:17.
Judah
5:17. And while they sin not before their God. Judah 5:17. And whilst they sin not before their God, they prosper.
That's right. So the scripture saying, while we sin not against the Heavenly Father, we prosper. You know, because ultimately this is Achior. You know, which he was known to be an Ammonite, you know, but, you know, I believe he was an Israelite. He was pretty much given hell for knees, you know, the information on the Israelites on pretty much how to take him down, when to attack him, and when not to attack him, you know. So he's given, you know, the Babylonians the history upon the Israelites at this present time. So as the brothers reading in the 17th verse, it says, while we sin not against the Heavenly Father, we prosper, because why? We was in order. You know, when you're in order, the Heavenly Father got no choice but to sup with Israel, you know, to deal with Israel, to give Israel everything that their heart could desire. Because why? We listening and we obeying to the things that he say and command us to do, you know? But when Esau puts that bait out there, going contrary to the word, that's when the Heavenly Father is justified in taking his stand, and the scripture is going to get into it. Go ahead.
Because the God that hated iniquity was with them.
Mm-hmm.
But when they departed from the way, you see that
the God that hated iniquity, mm-hmm. that hated sin, you know, you did perform the sin. The Most High that hated sin, man. Yahweh Bashem Yahusha that hated sin. You being wicked, you going off.
Yeah, but when they departed from the way which he appointed them, they were destroyed in many battles with their sword, and were led captives into a land that was not theirs. And the temple of their God was cast to the ground, and their cities were taken by the enemies.
And that's what happened during the Babylonian Empire, you know. Here it is, the Lord sent of prophets like Jeremiah, in which, you know, Israel didn't want to hearken to. You know, but they chose the devised mischief against, you know, so the Lord acknowledged that, the Lord witnessed that. And for them not hearkening nor receiving the message, the Lord set up Nebuchadnezzar, you know, as well as his army to what? Put Israel in captivity, you know, and destroy and to destroy the temple, you know, so that Yahweh Bashem Yahushua was justified in his doings, man. You know, and this is, like I said, Achior giving Hela for knees the understanding on how to deal with the Israelites, you know? And here it is, the works is recorded. You don't think Esau, you know, read this scripture? You don't think Esau read these passages on how to deal with us? That's why he's setting up everything going contrary to the Bible. Because as long as the nation of Israel goes contrary to the Bible, the longer he stays in power, the longer he could continue to dwell in his wickedness, because Israel is going off. But when that Lord, when the Lord got that number, you know, on one accord, 144,000 and one third, that's when he's able to send thermonuclear missiles on this place and leave it desolate, man. Go ahead.
Verse 19, but now are they returned to their God and are come up from the places where they were scattered.
That's right, and we're in a time now to where Israel's being gathered from the places we were scattered, man. See, brothers in Kenya waking up, brothers in Ghana waking up, brothers in South Africa waking up, brothers in the islands waking up, brothers all over Europe waking up, man. You know, Israel's coming back to their nationality, you know, whether they be of confusion of faces or not. You know, go ahead.
Verse and have possessed Jerusalem with their sanctuary is, and are sealed in the hill country, for it was desolate.
That's right. You know, so, but the point is that these devils, these Edomites, promote distractions to keep Israel away from their power. He sets up school, college,
education,
reality TV, rap contracts, the NBA, the NFL, doctrines, philosophies, different forms of religion, just to keep the nation of Israel from Yahweh, why Yahweh Shah, you know? Because he knows once Israel comes back to Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, he's finished. That's why ultimately we living in the time of Revelation 12 and 12. He's watching the videos, you know? So what the scriptures say, the devil shall come upon you with great wrath, knowing that he got but a short time to rule, man.
Yeah, what did you say? Yeah. This is Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 2, verse 10. Let us oppress the poor righteous man. Let us not spare the widow, nor reverence the great, the ancient great heirs of the age. Let our strength be the law of justice, for that which is feeble is found to be nothing wrong. Therefore, let us lie in wait for the righteous, because he is not for our turn. He is clean contrary of our doings. He upbraideth us as with our offending the law, and objective to our infamy, the transgressions of our education. He professeth to have the knowledge of Yahweh, and he calleth himself the child of the Lord. He is made to reprove our thoughts. He is grievous unto us even to behold, for his life is not like other men's. His ways are another fashion. He esteemeth of him as counterfeits. He abstaineth from our ways as from filthiness. He pronounces the end of the just to be blessed, and maketh his boast that Yahweh is his father. You know, so that's the word, that's the mindset of these Edomites. That's what they say when they see us. When they see our videos, they see the epistles, man. They say that, look, as he said here, he said, it says, in objective to our infamy, the transgressions of our education. And we talk about Esau's education. It's wicked. It's lies. It's not helping the Israelites. They want us to be oppressed or suppressed at the same time, and to go to the flow of their wicked mindset. They want Israel to be a certain way. Now, when you got kids, man, if you got kids, you know, brothers that got kids, and you around your kids, you can attest to this. You take your kids to school, you might go to parent conferences and shit like that. If you do, and you raise your child, you would know how these devils are trying to change your child's natural attitude, you know, which being an Israelite is. Lord told us in Genesis that we are not of the same fashion as Edom, you know. We're separated from Edom. We got different, we are totally different from Edomites. You can't raise an Israelite up, an Israelite child, as you would raise an Edomite child. It's two different natures. So their education, and even how they tell you to sit down in class, they deal with a boy, they say, you know, well, you know, he's a little jumpery, you know, but he's not that bad, but, you know, he kind of gets out of his seat. He's outspoken. I would like him to be a little more quiet, you know, not say certain words. Are you learning at home? Are you learning at home? You know, and it's like, bitch, if he ain't going off and disrupting the class or what you want to call it, why the hell you want me to change my son to be a fucking faggot? Yeah. Israelite kids, especially boys, man, listen, boys got testosterone. They are rot between their legs. You know, they're jitterbugs when it comes to moving around and learning. Kids are supposed to stand up and actually learn than them to and be hands-on than to actually sit down all fucking day in an hour, 2-3 hours in class and try to learn something. That ain't how men are. Women can do that, but not how men are, man. So their education, even in what they teach you about their history. They don't go into the scriptures. They don't tell you this truth. They're trying to teach you and mold you to be a fucking house nigga. You know, so that you can go into society and the system of this world so you can please either. Not please your how washing out shop, but please them. They love it when you're a faggot. You know, when you got feminine nature. They love it that you got a shaved beard and you all lined up Greek style. They love it when you talk soft. Yes, sir. You know? They love it when, but if you with your stern, Israel got a stern countenance about them, wear a beard, oh, he scares me. Yeah. Edom is naturally scared of Israelites. Yeah. You can walk down the street because of what they already think of all Jake as being criminals. You walking past an Edomite like Tupac did in Juice, boom, and a nigga jump. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They did. That was spiritual in that. That's a ghetto ass movie, but that was spiritual that Tupac did that because they walking down the street and you already know a white woman, she wrap up purse type. Cause you see you with brown faces, you know, and you ain't even, you could be a nigga that look like fucking Young Thug walking down the street and eating my, she's just because of your brown skin, she afraid of you, man.
That's right. This is Deuteronomy chapter 2. I'm gonna start at verse 1. You know, this is pretty much when Israel got delivered, you know, from the hand of Pharaoh in the land of Egypt, and he was going through the wilderness. It says, Deuteronomy 2 and 1, then we turned and took our journey into the wilderness by the way of the Red Sea. And Yahweh spake unto me, and we compassed Mount Seir many days. And Yahweh spake unto me, saying, you have compassed this mountain long enough. Turn you northward, and command that the people, saying, you are to pass through the coast of your brethren, the children of Esau, which dwell in Seir, and they shall be afraid of you. Take ye good heed unto yourselves, therefore, meddle not with them, for I will not give you of their land, no, not so much as a foot breadth, because I have given Mount Seir unto Esau for possession.
Yeah, and that's why they fear us, because the Most High sits with us, man.
That's right.
The Most High is with us, he's not DNA, man. He's all in our makeup, our genetic makeup, man. The way you look, the way you talk, the way your eye structures is, the way you gait, you laugh. You know, Israel laughs loud. You know, and it's like, he obnoxious, that's a radical. You know, Edom nature is not of us. You go into a restaurant, why he gotta be so loud? Why he can't be so silent like everybody else and be personal? You gait at the restaurant, loud as hell, and everybody knows. You know, we not like you fucking devils, man, and we will never be, and you can't force us to be. Even slavery taught you that.
Yep.
Hard bondage slavery. Yep. And then now the Lord is giving back our identity in his name, man, you devils is finished, man. Fuck out of here, man. But it's like it, man, it's like it. Nobody wants to be like you fucking devils, man. Nobody wants to eat like you. Nobody wants to talk like you. They passing on their fucking homosexual ways to the world and thinking the world's supposed to be like you. Fuck you. Fuck you devils, man. Nobody wants to be like you, man. We're not raising our kids to be like you. It's like it, man. See, I hate them devils, man.
It's good, bro.
Yeah. There you go. I was going to say, when you read that up, he said, you know, how Esau, basically when you read that wasn't Solomon 2, it shows you how Esau's studying the life, man. And what it is that, you know, through the spirit, we, you know, through the scriptures, we learn from the apostles, that Esau, you know, respects power, man. That's what it is, man. Esau, you know what I'm saying, when the Most High had a brother Red had his past through, you know what I'm saying, Edom and Mount Seir and shit, they knew that the Most High was with us, man. Even with the elect, they know that the Most High is with the elect, man, so they can't do anything to the elect, you know what I'm saying?
Even now, they know, even with the worst of Jake, they know the Most High is with us. Because they're afraid of us, man. Sports, entertainment. Why can this Jake do it like that? Why he look so finesse? How can he do it so easy, effortless? They know the powers with, I wish I could be like him. I wish I could do that. Why he gotta walk down the street like that?
Hey, what was white kids saying in the 90s? I wanna be like Mike. Mm-hmm. They were saying that in the 90s. Why? Because even the name Michael, the name itself means God-like. You know, one likened unto God, you know?
And quick scripture, brother, on the coming board, Lion Claw, put Exodus 15:15. Then the dukes of Edom shall be amazed. The mighty men of Moab trembling shall take hold upon them, and all the inhabitants of Canaan shall melt away.
It's that power, man. When the Most High come back, killing shit. You know, I say you won't stop with one press alone. It's just that power that they're gonna be afraid of, man. You know, now the Most High is not, you know what I'm saying, physically strong. So we know through faith, but to this world, faith is weak, man. I need to see, you know. So that's Esau's MO, man. You know, everything has to happen in the flesh, man. You know, it's that power, man. If you don't have, you know what I'm saying, if you don't have a gun, you know what I'm saying, or something with you, or you ain't, you know what I'm saying, or you know what I'm saying, us Israel, of course, we look weak right now. But that's the point, you know. Esau likes that power, man. He wants that power, man. You know, back in the scriptures that all of the nations feared us, but they know we had to be power with us.
Right. Even after the splitting of the Red Sea, the Israelites being delivered out of Egypt. You know, that went through the four corners of the earth. When the other kingdoms and heathens that ruled at the time, they knew of that event. And they said, look, is that the children of Israel? Is that the God of Israel? Is that the God of Israel? Is that the God of Israel? What you think the Lord going to do in this time when he delivered us through this great deliverance with his chariots flying in, scooping brothers up, swoop, whoop, swoop, 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 all that, man. What you gonna think the world gonna talk about then? When we rule on this earth, man, there ain't gonna be nothing to talk about. Because you're gonna be in subjection and being a slave if you're a heathen, man. These things are coming, man. Yahushua ain't coming back to be slaughtered and put on a cross again. He crazy if he think he's gonna do that again. You out of your mind. Everything only has to be done once, man. And just like telling these people about the truth. All you have to do is tell. I remember Apostle Sahar said that. You know, all you gotta do is tell you one time, that's it. Ain't gotta really keep going in and keep telling you over and over. Just tell you one time, and if you won't get it, then that's your loss, man. That's your loss.
I got this account that also showcases that these nations is afraid of Israel. You know, this is Joshua 2:9. It says, and she said unto the men, I know that Yahweh hath given you the land, and that your terror is falling upon us, and that all the inhabitants of the land faint because of you. For we have heard how the Yahweh dried up the water of the Red Sea for you when you came out of Egypt, and what you did unto the two kings of the Amorites that were on the other side, Jordan, Sihon, and Og, whom you utterly destroyed. And as soon as we had heard these things, our hearts did melt. Neither did there remain any more courage in any man because of you, for Yahweh, your power, he is power in heaven above and in earth beneath. You know?
That's powerful.
Yeah.
That's powerful.
It's going to happen again.
Yeah.
Because what Jeremiah 16:14 tells us.
Yeah.
What does that scripture tell us? That's a future prophecy, man.
Yeah.
That's a future prophecy that we patiently are waiting for, man. Because you nations is going to fear again. Here it is. You ain't fearing right now because, you know, we still in captivity. The so-called white man is in power. But once Yahweh Ba'asim Yahushua showcases his power and his elect, first and foremost of the nation of Israel, then you other nations going to begin to tremble once again. And and it's going to be from that point on, everlasting. You know, go ahead.
This is Jeremiah chapter 16:14. Mm-hmm. It says, therefore, behold, the days come, say the Lord Yahweh, that it shall no more be said, the Lord Yahweh liveth, that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. But the Lord Yahweh liveth, that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north.
The north is what? Talking about North America, man. United States of America. Go ahead.
It says, and from all the lands, whether he had driven them.
Because why? Israel was scattered around the four corners of the earth, as we read in Ezekiel, the 36th chapter, among other scriptures that speak upon Israel being scattered. Go ahead.
And I will bring them again into their land that I gave unto their fathers.
And what land is that? The nation, the land of Israel, you know, Jerusalem. You know, though we are a people before us, a place, you know, but here it is. The Lord is going to bring us back into Israel, you know, the land over there to where these devils pretty much got kosher pigs and Tel Aviv and all of these faggots running rampant. That's why that place needs a great ethnic cleansing, man. You know, it's going to be utterly destroyed to get rid of all of that wickedness and the foul abomination that's currently dwelling there, man. You know?
Yeah, and that's one thing the Lord is nature's good for, is breaking down and building back up. It's nothing to the Lord to break down and build back up. That's what he about. That's what he loves to do. Because he's a builder. He's a creator, man. So it's nothing to the Lord to break something down like he did with us as prophets. When you come into this truth, you're going to get broken down. You're going to get broken down to the point to where you're going to have to be built back up, because the Lord, he break your building down and he builds you back up stronger. You know, when you a man of the Lord, a prophet of the Lord, doing this work for the Lord, he breaks and gets rid of all the leaven that's inside you, all your weak points that you was weak on in the world, in your mind, he breaks it all up. He brings you to a low to where you cry, man. You be like, damn, why am I really at this state? You may not understand it, but if you got the faith in the Lord and hold your integrity, you're going to know why the Lord did it to you later. One thing about being with the Lord, you got to be patient. The Heavenly Father is patient. He is time. So ain't nothing. No, see, for us to be creatures, we in the flesh, so we desire things fast. Mm-hmm. But the Lord had to put his spirit over us and to guide us for us to suffer and patient and to still hold unto our integrity. One thing as a living for the spirit, you gotta learn patience. You gotta learn to wait, which is suffering because you're waiting. So you have to learn how to wait. You gotta wait for the Lord to make a move. You gotta wait for the Lord to react. That's why when you wait and when the Lord do make a move, you greatly rejoice in his name. Yahweh Shemel Shah, the water. Praises Yahweh Shemel Shah. That's what's gonna happen when you scoffers get dealt with, when the Lord finally meets you at your door. And he whacks that ass and text that ass. Okay. And then the men of the Lord gonna rejoice in the name of the Lord and praise Yahweh Shemel Shah. Lord wants the glory, man. And he deserves it. He deserves it, him and Yahweh Shah. Yahweh Shah deserves it. That's why we worship him. We're supposed to worship him. And it's all righteous to worship them. You got niggas playing trickery of the mind, you know, and playing on a simple. Man, I'll tell you this, man. You listening to these demons and you flocking to their videos and giving them views and give them this encouragement to think that they're doing something? Shame on you. If you believe in that bullshit. Now, if you watching just to stay tuned with what's going on, cool. But if you get seduced in the spirit by these niggas, man, the Lord gonna kill you just along with these niggas, man. If you really think that these niggas that's grabbing brothers' identity, I'm just like grabbing brothers' personal information, putting it out there, is you think, if you really think that's gonna stop them from teaching this word, you is a fucking fool, and you've been sucked by the demons. You've been sucked and taken by the demons, man. What you gonna do, a man that don't got shit, you glorifying this man and giving him more encouragement to go more hard in the spirit. You stupid motherfuckers. And I said it like that. And I meant to say it like that. You stupid motherfuckers. You stupid. Because you don't understand the spirit. You don't understand the spirit. You're not about to shame this man that he can't go teach. We're supposed to go, you know, damn, they brought that out on me. Damn, yo. My name, they put my government name out there. Damn, yo. So I have like 3 more videos.
Yeah,
call my job, son. Damn, yo, man. I think I need to slow down. Get the fuck out of here. Gonna go harder, man. This truth, we know that what? This truth is serious and your life is on the line, man. You gave up everything in the world when you came into this truth. Now that's talking about the real men of the Lord that's still holding their integrity to this truth after you flame them with fire. So what? You glorifying these men. And the Lord gonna tax you, man. It's like you, man. You gonna change something.
Hey, but just to go back, you know, to where we started as far as truth, right? This is 1st Ezra chapter 4, verse 39. It says, with her, there is no accepting of persons or rewards, but she doeth the things that are just and refraining from all unjust and wicked things. And all men do well like of her works. It's talking about truth. It says, neither in her judgment is any unrighteousness, and she is the strength, kingdom, power, and majesty of all ages. Blessed be the power of truth. And with that he held his peace, and all the people then shouted and said, great is truth and mighty above all things. Then said the king unto him, ask what thou wilt more than is appointed in the writing, and we will give it thee.
Hey, real quick, I can count on that. Mm-hmm. That's why, you know what I'm saying, you gotta, you know what I'm saying, go into scripture and truly believe and fear, man. You niggas that, you know, went outside of scripture, most times gonna destroy you. And the scriptures, like, you know, I was talking to the brother one day, the juiciest part of the scripture is when, you know how on the Most High by seeing Elijah or this or a different prophet, he'll put the word in his mouth, but the juiciest part of the scripture when that prophecy actually come to pass. Like, oh shit, I remember that. You know what I'm saying? So in the scriptures, the most I always say, you know, the light of the tabernacle of the wicked shall be put out. The light of the tabernacle of the wicked shall be put out. And he speaks about how on the wicked, the Most High destroyed, like when going to Jeroboam. The Most High destroyed him and his whole family, man. Different wicked dudes in the scriptures, the Most High destroyed them and their whole family, you know. So you niggas gonna be destroyed, man. And that's why we fear the Lord.
Sure. We fear the Lord to destroy men. You know? We fear the Lord because we know the terror of the Lord. We know that the Lord can actually do you what he will do to you if you don't obey by his word. And when you go and scoffing it and you causing death to come upon you, you cause it upon yourself. You playing with something that's real. That's why Mike Epps catching hell. Not to harp on that nigga, but that's why he's catching hell, because why? He tried to play with the spirit. There's certain things you don't joke with, and certain things you just don't do. And that's dealing with Yahweh Bashem Yahushua. And you people gonna learn it. You can despise that. And another thing, you can despise the men. Slap him.
Let me tell why he grabbed this real quick.
It's 2 Corinthians 6 and 9, as unknown and yet well known, okay? Because what? To the world, you know, we despise, so we are known. For what? Lord willing, you know, we chosen of the Heavenly Father, you know what I'm saying? So all that matters is that Yahweh and Yahweh shall actually recognize our name. So the hell with everybody else. As unknown and yet well known, as dying, and behold, we live. Because what? We dying within this world. We dying, you know what I'm saying, according to the society standards. You know, our flesh is being killed every day as we grow within this truth, so our spirit can live more for the Lord. As chastened and not killed, as sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, as poor, yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing all things. So, you know, as a brother getting into, you know, the guys that's carnal, you know, they mentioning all these different things, but we done cast off all the burdens of man already. So while we worried about all of the carnal shit, the job, and this, then the third, because we know the Lord can restore those things right back into us in 10 times more and put more blessings upon us for us going through that hell and for us suffering that as men, girding up our loins, man. So you guys and brothers are getting into it. You don't need brother giving brothers more than glory in the more sure word of the testimony that this is the truth, man. And you really solidifying brother's spots that they may have the hope that may be of the hope for lack, man.
Yeah, I'll tell you this. If I see my face on your channel, brother, I mean, stop getting a brother. If I see my face on this channel, I'm a comment and say the water. And for real, I comment and say the water.
And quote a scripture, John 7:7.
Right. The water. You know? Stupid motherfuckers. This is 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, and I started 6. It says that no man go beyond and defraud his brother in any matter, because the Lord is the avenger of all such, as we also have forewarned you and testified. Verse 7, for Yahweh hath not called us unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. Verse 8, now that's the point. He therefore that despiseth not man, but Yahweh, who hath also given us of his Holy Spirit. So when these people despise the word, they think you hurting us. We're nobody. You can talk about us all day. We gave our body as a living sacrifice. Do your worst. Do your will. Do that. Because we're nobody, because this thing is not about us. It's about Yahweh, Bashem Yahweh Shai. And through his men, he's going to get glorified. Yahweh Shai walked this and went through. And they beat the living hell out of Yahweh Shai, man. And yet, because Yahweh Shai had to go through that to be the sacrifice lamb for the elect, well, for all of Israel. But in particular, the elect, you know? So we ain't nobody. So I'm going to read that again.
We nobody, but we somebody.
Nobody but somebody. It says, he therefore that despiseth not man, but Yahweh, who have also given us the Holy Spirit. So you don't despise us. You're not hurting us. You can kill us all day long. Paul said it. I am killed all the day. We killed all the day long. So, but we love us through him. Be more conquerors through him that love us, man. So, yeah, with us, Lord, take us out and build us back up. Doesn't matter. But you know, the Lord's telling you here in Thessalonians that what? You don't despise. You're not really despising man because your hatred of what these men are talking about going out weekly and week out. You despising the Heavenly Father that sent them, man. And I made this point when in the lesson I did. It's like, for an example, with messengers. So therefore, if you work at a job and you're an employee, right? And you're a servant working at the job, and the boss, who you barely get to contact and talk to, he sends his supervisor to say, I need you to tell John Joe that he needs to do this and he needs to do that. But you, John Joe, and here you go, supervisor, hey, look, man, you got to start working, doing this. You got to come to the job, blah, 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 blah. You going to tell the supervisor, man, I ain't about to fucking do that. What the fuck you talking about? Yo, come on, man. Yo, that's too much, this and that. Now, you not despising the supervisor. You despising the one that sent him. It's the same thing in his truth, man. Stupid niggas. It's dumb, man.
You know, I got me,
yes, man.
Yes, I got. It's 1 Ezra chapter 4, verse 40. It says, neither in her judgment is any unrighteousness, and she is the strength, kingdom, power, and majesty of all ages. Blessed be the power of truth. And with that, he held his peace, and all the people then shouted and said, great is truth and mighty above all things, you know, because why? Truth reigns supreme, you know. The how by Shem Yahushua represents truth. And I just want to get 1 Ezra chapter 3, verse 12, when they was getting into who's the most wicked or powerful, I'm sorry, whether it be women, wine, or the king, you know, and it says, 1 Ezra 3 and 12, the third rule, women are strongest, but above all things, truth beareth away the victory. Because it's because of this truth being published throughout the four corners of the earth that Yahweh by Shem Yahushua is shortening the days for the elect's sake. Yeah? You know, this truth is causing these Edomites to start scrambling, man. They don't know whether they're coming or going. You know, they don't know how to deal with us. But that's why they call themselves trying to frame mischief by law, you know, to try to contain us. But like the scriptures say, you can't do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. Man.
Yeah, with the truth, you don't have to keep a secret. It's truth. Truth, you don't have to hide.
Yeah.
You don't have to say, you can't hide the truth. Because the truth trumps over all lies. Mm-hmm. So the truth, you don't have to be a mystery, you know? The scriptures is no longer a mystery. Because the prophets are breaking it down. The Lord opened the book. So the Bible is not a mystery anymore. It is to those that don't understand it. But it's not anymore because you got people slacking. You got prophets, anointed teachers, starting with the apostle and elders, the great millstone, breaking down the mysteries. That's truth. You don't have to be in the shadows like Batman and not show your face. This is why we show our face. We come before the unicorn and show you who we are, saying what we're saying. Boldly, standing stiffly for the name of Yahweh Shah.
The truth is simple, it's clear cut. You know what I'm saying? Like with lies, you know what I mean? You gotta untangle all these different webs and you gotta deal with a bunch of bullshit, man.
Dealing with deception.
Yeah, dealing with deception, like the brother said, man. But truth is clear cut, it's clear to the point, man. It's just, you know what I'm saying, one road, man. You know, a lie, now you gotta look at the fork in the road. Well, which way do I go? But truth is an easy path, you know what I'm saying, for you to recognize. It's a hard path to walk, but it's an easy path to recognize, man.
I'm gonna say this for the record. The whooping stick is Edomites.
Clown.
The whooping stick is Edom. So if you're a part of Edom, we got you. We okay. All right. You see, I ain't it. Or you a pawn that's being used by the agents. Because agents will do that too.
Yeah.
They feel as though you got this spirit in you. You know, you hate Great Millstone, right? And you ain't getting paid. They getting paid. Why wouldn't they use you for a source, nigga? Because of your passion and your vendetta against Great Millstone.
Yeah, I'm gonna read these last few scriptures. This pertains to different points that we were just touching on, but Lionfall plus some beautiful scriptures. I start from Deuteronomy 28:10. And all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee. Going into the point, I would say Esau, you know, is afraid of us. Psalms 25:5. Lead me in thy truth and teach me. For thou art the power of my salvation. On thee do I wait all the day. Our brother Woes get into with the patience. 2 Corinthians 1:9. Yeah. For we had the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves.
Exactly.
But in Yahweh, which raiseth the dead. We dead right now. So why would we trust in ourselves, man? Read that again. For we had the sentence of death in ourselves. The moment we entered into this truth, that sentence of death was made for this world, man. We dead into the world, man. The scriptures talk about mortifying members, man. You know? So that's what we're doing day in and day out, putting off that mortal man and putting on the spiritual man, man. The man that's after seeking after Yahweh and the Son, Yahweh Shah. You want to add up?
Yeah, I got a quick precept. This is Mark 10:18. It says, and Yahweh Shah said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is Yahweh. You know? That speaks for itself. You know, Yahweh Shah even said, why callest thou me good? There is only one good but Yahweh. That's holy and pure and true. Mm-hmm. Yahweh Shah is pure and true too. You know, but when he walked the earth, he was in the flesh, man. You know? When he was Solomon, whether you receive it or not, he sinned. But he came as Yahweh Shah, perfect, man. But he still knew of his past and him being in the flesh. Being in this wicked flesh, man, is sin, man. It's sin. It's sin. You know? And that's why we praying for the Lord to bring forth, you know, this the kingdom, so that what? We can have our new bodies, man. Yeah, I buy new bodies, man. So I don't give a damn what you niggas talking about or whatever what you say. We ain't got shit. So glorify us, you know? Talk about us so we can be glorified. That's our living. Like, you know, it's a thing when you come to this truth, you gotta learn, you know, to love the hate. The hate that's coming to you, that gives you fire and energy, man.
That's right.
You're helping out our souls, man. But it's truth. The Lord told us scoffers shall come in the end. In the last days.
That prepares us for the battle with that great
day. Yeah. Right. Ain't doing nothing, stopping nobody. Man. Stop it.
I say this. We love the hate while you love to hate.
He was wrapping up.
Yeah. Let me read through these last verses real quick. 2 Corinthians 1:9. For we had the sentence of death in ourselves, that we should not trust in ourselves, but in Yahweh, which raised the dead. Psalms 26:3. For thy loving kindness is before my eyes, and I have walked in thy truth. Psalms 31:5. Into thine hand I commit my spirit. Damn. Thou hast redeemed me, O Lord Yahweh, of truth, man. So in our hands, we commit ourselves unto the Lord. So our lives, anything, or you want to humiliate us, none of that shit matters. Because at the end of the day, we don't fear man, we fear Yahweh and Yahweh Shah, man. That can destroy both body and spirit in hell, man, according to the scripture, you know.
Why I'm saying what I'm saying is spiritual, because brothers don't give a fuck. Because why? Yahweh Shah is not a man to hold a reputation. We don't hold no reputations.
Exactly.
We don't come into this truth holding a reputation for people to admire and want to, you know, we got this fame. We're fame. I got this thing. I never lose. I'm all from scripture. I'm badass. We don't hold that spirit. Humble and lowly is what we are. We don't got shit. We don't care for that. When you got a reputation, yeah, that may matter to a man that ain't right. That's carrying a reputation. Want to be looking like something, man, we don't give a fuck. We don't give a fuck, man. It's being honest. We don't carry no reputation. It is what it is. And suffering for your house shine is great gain. That's it, man.
Oh, no, I was going to say, like the brother said, we in hell, man. We on the fucking Esau. We on the white man trying to carry reputation.
That makes sense.
So, you know, hey, with that, you know, we hope this segment was edifying, you know, to brothers out there, you know what I'm saying, through the spirit of Yahweh, Bashmi Yahweh Shah, you know, brothers, let's just keep pushing, give diligence, death and destruction, you know what I'm saying, Lord willing, you know what I'm saying, Trump, keep these things moving, you know what I mean, the prophecies moving, so on and so forth, you know, brothers, stay strong in the faith, you know what I'm saying, we definitely almost up out of here, Lord willing. The water to the brothers that tuned in, you know what I'm saying, onto our live stream and commented, you know what I'm saying, appreciate it and all that. So with that, like to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shah, double honors to the apostles and the elders of great millstone, and shalom to like out there, doing this work of faith, and labor with love and true sincerity. Shalom.
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 To the elect,